Welcome to another edition of The Hoop Scoop. I'm Jarret Johnson. I have bad news this time for Red Raider fans out there. As I think most of you, if you're watching this by now, you know that Nimari Burnett, freshman guard, former McDonald's All-American, has transferred out or has announced that he is transferring out and leaving the Texas Tech program. You know, I'd be lying if I said I saw this coming. Maybe with his struggles so far early in his freshman year, could I see him possibly transferring after the season? But did I see him transferring 12 games into his freshman season? No, I did not. And I think The Athletic was the first to report this. And 24/7 Sports has since confirmed that Nimari is, in fact, transferring out. His name is expected to be in the transfer portal very soon. And, you know, he just played Tuesday nights. Thursday morning when this came to light, you know, he played Tuesday night in Texas Tech's 82-71 Kansas State victory over Kansas State. So, you know, bang, bang there. But if you look back at that game, a lot of things happened. Now, the Red Raiders won, but Burnett only played 6 minutes. He had 2 points, two rebounds in 6 minutes. Also, Coach Beard, as he does a lot, but more so this year, I think, than I remember in the past, you know, he was very animated and in the players' faces during the timeouts. And, you know, the bottom line is, I think Burnett is leaving because of his struggles and his lack of playing time. And I think everything else is going to be secondary. But I also think, you know, look, he's the second guy to transfer. Second guy that you were counting on in basically the top eight of your rotation to transfer out. And Tech's only played a dozen games. So, you know, with Joel and Tomboy leaving after, what, just three games, and now Nimari Burnett leaving after a dozen games, you know, something isn't working because obviously, Coach Beard brought those guys in to play. He liked those guys. They're talented guys, highly coveted guys. And, you know, a bunch of other programs wanted them for their own programs. And make no mistake, there'll be a lot of schools fighting for Nimari Burnett. But both of them transferred out because of a lack of playing time. I mean, it's obvious to see. And I think also Beard's style is just, it's not for everyone. I think that's just the bottom line. I don't agree with, there's been some talk about, you know, how much have players actually improved under Coach Beard and his staff. Well, they've improved a lot, several players. Now, you want to talk about just his recruits. I think Zaire Smith, just in that one season, his development was amazing. And then, of course, Jarrett Culver ended up being the Big 12 Player of the Year in just his second season. We'll have to see how some of these other guys, like I think Terrence Shannon has showed a lot of improvement from his first year to now. I think he's one of the best players in the Big 12. I think he's an all Big 12 performer, especially if Texas Tech ends up winning more you know, the rest of the season. So, you know, we'll have to see. I think Dominic Moretti got better, though he struggled his junior year. I think overall from when he got to the program to when he left, he was a much better player. You know, all those guys that Beard inherited, of course, like Keenan, and man, you just go down the list. Just some really good players. Zach Smith, even though he was hurt a lot. Odiasi, all those guys improved greatly under Coach Beard and his staff. Now, Coach Beard's staff has undergone a lot of changes just since he's been here. So you've had a lot of, even for Coach Beard, who has done a great job throughout his career of producing and developing like a totally new roster. Like year in and year out. I mean, he even did that in Arkansas Little Rock. So he's been very successful at doing that. But, I mean, he's had so much turnover in his time at Texas Tech, including his staff, that, man, you just got to wonder what kind of toll that has taken. And then, like I said, I think, you know, with the lack of playing time, in both cases of in Tomboy, who was like seventh or eighth off the bench when he left, and then a guy like Nimari Burnett, McDonald's All-American, who wasn't starting. He didn't start any of his 12 games, was averaging just 17 minutes a game. I think he averaged just over 5 points, 1.8 rebounds, 1.4 steals in those 17 minutes a game. And his shooting woes have been, I mean, I think he shot like 28% from the field, like 17% from three or something, just something god-awful like that. So he wasn't shooting well. He wasn't getting a lot of playing time. Tech hasn't necessarily been that successful this year. I mean, 9-3, they're number 18, 2-2 in Big 12 so far this season. So it just seems like a lot has gone wrong, you know, certainly compared to our preseason expectations. And then and Burnett just decided, you know, it was time to go. Obviously, it felt like he felt like he wasn't being utilized like he should be. So, you know, I think there's differing opinions on that, and I'm not one to say, oh, you should feel this way or that way. But this is what happened. So, we'll have to see. The Riveters still have a lot of talent. They still have a chance to have a good season. But, I mean, it would be disingenuous not to acknowledge that. I mean, Tech lost two of their top eight or nine players in the rotation a dozen games into the season. That is not a good sign. We'll have to see what happens, how they progress from this, what Coach Beard says. As of now, the program hasn't said anything. We'll just have to see what he says about it and how the team responds. So, with that, I want to thank you for watching, and until next time.